So today we are to revise HTML basics. Okay. Clear. So parallel type the coding with me. We'll be starting with the basics first. I said recording is on. Be quiet. The first tag is HTML tag. Followed by the head tag. Right? Inside the head tag, we have title tag, and I'm giving the title revision D. Revision D. This is the title I'm giving. D. You can give any name. This name you will see on the title bar of the browser window. All of you will type the coding parallel to me. Then only you will have the benefit of practical lab. Offline, online class, if you are assessing the meeting from computer or laptop, you also please practice side by side. And you can show me on the video whatever work you are doing. Here I close the head tag. Side by side, I'll be asking you questions also, treating it as a case study. Okay, so be alert. Followed by the body tag. First question, only you have to raise your hand. One question from offline, one question from online. Turn for offline class. From the following tags typed above, which one is the structural tag? I said only raise your hand. Rian, all above. All the above tags are structural tags. Okay, question for online students. Nobody will raise hand in the offline now. Another name of structural tag is dash tags. Another name of structural tag is dash tag. Yes, online class, raise your hand. Hurry up, be fast in feedback. Anyone? Am I audible to them? Yes, I am audible. Yes, beta. Bisham, are you here in the lecture? Yes, you answer this question, Bisham. Another name for structural tags. The word starts from B. B for bat. Yeah, I think they have got the clue. Yes, Sayam, unmute yourself.
Basic tags.
Very right. Basic tags. So structural tags are also called as basic tags. Okay. There are two types of tag. One is container, other one is dash. Empty tags. Right now, all the tags which I have typed are container tags. Container tags are those tags which have both opening as well as closing. Empty tags are those tags which have only opening but not closing. So now moving further, I am using H1 as the heading element to display the prominent heading. I am using the align attribute of heading element, and I am giving the center alignment. My heading is revision 1. Revision 1. Divyanshu, you're not typing. Revision 1. And close the H1. Close the H1 tag. All right. So this is my heading, revision 1. It will be appearing in the center of the page. because I have used align attribute of heading element. I have given the value center. Okay. Now you can specify the color also for the heading. I am giving the color using the font tag. Font tag is used to specify the color, size and style for the particular segment of text. Okay. So I am giving the color here red. If I want to change the style of the font, Bissam, I have seen better. Good. I have seen the work. Nice. If I want to change the font of the text, the style, the attribute is not style. Attribute is face. Okay. Face equal to, I am giving Verdana. You can give any face as per your choice. Okay. Clear? So after this, I want to draw one line which moves in the horizontal direction across the full width of the screen, and that I can give with the help of HR tag. That is possible with the help of HR tag. HR stands for horizontal rule. The first attribute of HR is color. Specify the color of the horizontal rule here. I am giving the color blue. Size. Size attribute of HR tag specifies the thickness of the line. How much your line is thick. Okay. So I am giving the size 4. Bete, you can give any color, any size as per your choice. Okay. Then I am closing the HR here. HR tag is empty tag. Do not give the empty HR tag here. HR is empty tag. Now I am not giving width attribute. Width attribute of HR specifies the length of HR. Size specifies thickness. Width specifies how much area of screen it will cover. I am not giving width attribute. So by default, it will cover entire width area of the screen. Okay, clear? Now here I would like to start a list. A list is a sequence of items, either having number or having bullets. So I am creating, first of all, the list with bullets. I am typing here my first list, UL. UL stands for unordered list. Unordered list. All right. Again, raise your hand for the question. Consider to be the case study question. This question is for Rhythm. I'll announce the name. Only that child will give the answer. And no other child will speak the answer. What is another name for unordered list, beta? You have any idea about it, Rhythm? It is called bulleted list, beta. Okay, now you get it. Bulleted list. Clear? Okay. Second question for online students. If any online child knows the answer, raise your hand. Name the attribute of unordered list. Nobody will speak in the offline class. Yes, online class. Okay. Bissam. Yes, bete.
Type.
Type attribute. Very right. So UL list has one attribute that is called type. And the value of type attribute is disk, square, or circle. Disk, square, or circle. It can have three possible bullets. I am giving the first bullet, disk. Now see here, if I am not giving any value, I am not specifying the type attribute. I am only specifying the UL tag name. By default, the list which will appear in disk. The default bullet is disk, okay? But particularly, if you want to specify, then you can specify by using the type attribute and giving the value disk. Clear? Now, whatever options or items you want in the list, that you can specify by giving list item tag. That is li. Li is list item. The number of options you want, the number of times you specify the li tag. If you want 5 options, mention li tag 5 times with the options. I am giving first option HTML. Second option I am giving body. Third option I am giving font. Fourth option I am giving H1. Next option I am giving head. Next option I am giving UL. I am giving here UL. Okay. So these are the options which I have typed. Now here I would like to close my list. Now after closing my list, I again give here HR tag with different color. Right? That is all I want for my first revision page. So I am closing the body tag over here. Okay. I am closing the HTML tag over here. Saving this web page inside documents. Revision 10th D.html. Let us see the browser view. Going in documents. Opening with Google Chrome. Silence class. See, this is your first web page. I can increase the zoom level. Rehan, take your seat. Right? Now, you have to make one change. I want the list to be appearing in alphabetic form A, B, C, D, E. Okay. So for that, what we are going to do, we'll be using order list. Order list is a list in which all the options or items, they are arranged in particular order, maybe in numbered form or in alphabetic form, right? And the type attribute of order list has 5 possible values. 1, 2, 3, which is the default value, lower ABC, capital ABC, lower Roman, capital Roman. Okay, I am giving here small ABC, right? Clear? Am I clear to all? I am specifying the color here.
W, and I am closing the font tag over here. I'm saving the changes done. Check it out. I have changed the color of the list also. By applying the font tag, I have changed the color of the list options. Specify the font tag above the list. And you can specify any color in which you want the items of the list to appear. Yes, online class, things are clear. Path same. Now, after the order list, let us proceed to the next list, that is the definition list. In definition list, we have, okay, wait, before that, let me tell the role of start attribute. You don't want the list to be starting from A letter. Irrespective, you want in lower ABC, but you want the list to start with letter E. Mathematically, the number of E is 5. So you write value 5 in the start attribute. Start attribute of OL tag always take numeric value as its value. Okay? You cannot pass alphabetic value here. You cannot type E here. It always take numeric value. So mathematically, letter E is having value 5. Right? And start attribute is only available in order list. Check it. Now the list appears starting from letter E and going up till the corresponding sequence. Clear? Am I clear, online class? Now suppose I am giving here 26. That is the last number of the last letter, Z. See the LCD first. If the value of start attribute is 26. That is the number of the last letter Z. After Z, the list starts with AA, AB, AC, AD. First alphabet will be A for all, then followed by the second character, which is normal ABC. Okay? Am I clear? You also practice this coding. Hurry up, please. Now proceeding to definition list. By name, it is very much clear. It displays the term and its definition. Term in one line. Its definition in another line. And to specify the definition list, I'll be using DL tag. DL tag stands for definition list. To specify the term which is to be defined, I'll be giving DT tag. Definition term. In the DT tag, specify the term to be defined. I am giving the term internet. Okay. Now in the next tag, that is the DD tag, definition description. DD tag stands for definition description. Here I'll be writing the definition of the term. Internet is the worldwide network of networks and close DD. Then DT. I'm giving here the term URL. DD tag, it refers to the address of file on internet. Okay. Then third term I am giving HTML. It is the language used to create web pages. Here I close the DL tag. Okay. Now let us check the browser view. Check it out. Term in one line, Rayan. Term in one line, its definition in another line. Now you create one definition list coding. I tell you which terms you have to take. First term you take UL. Define UL tag. Okay. So first term will be UL. Second term B tag, bold tag. Third term you take U tag, underline tag. Okay. Inko define karo one line mein. UL, bold and underline. Specify their definition in one line by using the definition list. Hurry up. And I want the entire definition area to be displayed in maroon color. So you have to specify the font color over here. Right? Font color equal to maroon, and your text will appear in the same color that you have defined. Yes, online class, any doubt? Any queries, online class? Offline class? Finish your typing fast. Time is about to go. Just raise your hand, whatever you want to ask. Wait.